India has successfully fired nuclear-capable submarine-launched K-4 ballistic missile. The test was executed off the coast of Andhra Pradesh, which is located in the southern part of India. The missile under development will be deployed on indigenous Arihant-class nuclear-powered submarines of the Indian Navy. As per reports, the test firing of the missile was carried out from an underwater platform in the sea. This test is a major landmark for India as it gets ready to field an operational nuclear triad. In this video, Defense Updates discusses why Arihant-class submarine, armed with K-4 submarine-launched ballistic missile, is the most lethal weapon of India. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft or ship, and 3 days of premium account. In December 1971, during the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971, U.S. President Richard Nixon sent a carrier battle group named Task Force 74, led by the nuclear-powered USS Enterprise, into the international waters of the Bay of Bengal in a show of force. In those days, the U.S. was hostile towards India, as India was close to the Soviet Union. In response, the Soviet Union had sent a submarine armed with nuclear missiles from Vladivostok to trail the U.S. task force. The Soviet submarine surfaced when the Americans appeared. It was done to demonstrate to them that the Soviet Union had positioned a nuclear submarine in the Indian Ocean, and this prevented any intervention by the U.S. in the ongoing war. The event demonstrated the significance of nuclear weapons and ballistic missile submarines to then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Following the 1974 Smiling Buddha nuclear test, the Indian government ordered the feasibility study for an indigenous nuclear propulsion system. The Indian Navy's Advanced Technology Vessel, ATV, project to design and construct a nuclear submarine took shape in the 1990s. Ballistic missile submarines are generally nuclear-powered and carry long-range nuclear-tipped missiles, also known as SLBM, or submarine-launched ballistic missiles. Nuclear strikes can be carried out from land, air, and sea, and this is known as the nuclear triad. Nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines are considered to be the most potent weapon developed by mankind, as they are the most survivable part of the nuclear triad. A surprise preemptive strike might wipe out a country's land-based missiles and nuclear bombers, but it's very difficult to track and take out ballistic missile submarines patrolling quietly in the depths of the ocean. Since they can't be taken out by first strike and can retaliate against an enemy with SLBMs, no sane adversary will attack a country that possesses a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine armed with SLBMs. The importance of these can be gauged from the fact that 14 ballistic missile submarines of American Ohio class together carry approximately 50% of the total U.S. active inventory of strategic thermonuclear warheads. SLBM-armed nuclear-powered submarine is especially significant for India as it has no first use of nuclear weapons policy. Nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines are very complex and costly to develop. This is why the US, Russia, UK, France, China, and India are currently the only countries to field a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine. Furthermore, integrating SLBMs with them is a major engineering challenge. K-4 K-4 is one of the two underwater missiles that were being developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization of India, other being the smaller K-15. The K-series missiles are named after Indian scientist and former Indian president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Viewers may note that he is called the Missile Man of India, as he made major contributions to India's missile programs. K-4 is a nuclear-capable, intermediate-range submarine-launched ballistic missile. It weighs 17 tons, has a length of 12 meters, and a diameter of 1.3 meters. The missile is solid-fueled and has an accuracy of 20 to 30 meters CEP. It is not MIRV, Multiple Independent Reentry Vehicle, enabled as of now. It will carry a single nuclear warhead with a yield equivalent of 200 to 250 kilotons of TNT. For comparison, Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. K-4 has an estimated range of 3,500 kilometers or 2,175 miles. The missile is being developed to arm the fleet of the Arihant-class nuclear submarines being built by India. India is expected to carry out more tests on the missile. The Arihant-class, meaning the Slayer of Enemies, is a class of nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines being built for the Indian Navy under the Advanced Technology Vessel Project. INS Arihant is the first vessel of this class, and it's India's first indigenous ballistic missile submarine. INS Arihant displaces around 6,000 tons. It has a length of 365 feet, or 111 meters. It's powered by an 83-megawatt nuclear reactor that drives a single 7-blade propeller. The submarine has a maximum speed of 12 to 15 knots, or 22 to 28 kilometers per hour, when surfaced, and 24 knots, or 44 kilometers per hour, when submerged. It's thought to be able to operate at depths of 1,150 feet, or 350 meters. INS Arihant has unlimited range and endurance limited only by essential supplies. It's equipped with USHUS, which is an integrated sonar system. It's used for detonating and tracking enemy submarines, surface vessels, and torpedoes, and can be used for underwater communications and avoiding obstacles. The sonar can work in both active and passive mode, and is capable of interception and underwater communication. In November 2018, INS Arihant successfully completed its first deterrence patrol. Hailing INS Arihant's achievement, Indian Prime Minister Modi had said, "A credible nuclear deterrence is the need of the hour." The submarine has 4 launch tubes. It will be able to carry 4 K-4s or 12 K-15s. INS Arihant has 533mm torpedo tubes for launching torpedoes. However, these are intended primarily for self-defense. Ballistic missile submarines are not meant to proactively hunt enemy ships and submarines, but their mission is to lay low and provide the enemy as little a chance as possible to detect them. India has already built the second submarine of this class, named INS Arigat. It's currently undergoing trials and is expected to be commissioned later this year. It's interesting to note that INS Arigat is larger than INS Arihant and is powered by a nuclear reactor having more capacity. INS Arigat will be able to carry 8 K-4s or 24 K-15s. With K-4, India will be able to strike deep inside China when launched from the Bay of Bengal. India has plans to build 4 submarines of the Arihant class. Once deployed, these will together carry 28 K-4 SLBMs, 4 in the first and 8 in each of the other 3. The fleet will be massively destructive and will act as a major deterrence, as it will greatly increase India's second strike capabilities. It's interesting to note that India is also working on K-5 and K-6 missiles that will have much longer range, be MIRV enabled, and will be deployed in a new series of ballistic missile submarine.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.